Ever wondered how a war could be cold? What were the superpowers really fighting over during the Cold War? Welcome to the intriguing era of the Cold War, a time of intense rivalry and tension between two superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union. This wasn't your typical war with battlefields and armed soldiers. Instead, it was a clash of ideologies, an epic struggle between capitalism and communism. The term Cold War is a bit of a misnomer because there were no direct military confrontations between the US and the Soviet Union. However, the temperature was at boiling point, with each side vying for global domination, not with bullets and bombs, but with political maneuvering, propaganda, and economic pressure. It was a war fought in the shadows, behind closed doors, and in the minds of millions across the globe. So, buckle up as we embark on this journey of unraveling the complex dynamics of the Cold War. The embers of World War II were yet to cool off when the Cold War started heating up. As the world emerged from the horrors of global conflict, two superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union, began to assert their influence. The stage for this was initially set at the Yalta and Potsdam conferences, where leaders of the Allied powers gathered to discuss the future of war-torn Europe. At Yalta, the seeds of tension were sown as the leaders grappled with the fate of Eastern Europe. The Potsdam Conference further fueled these disagreements, with the division of Germany and Berlin into four occupational zones sparking off disputes. This was more than just a power struggle. It was an ideological clash: democracy versus communism, capitalism against socialism. The rivalries that began in these post-war conferences would define global politics for decades. Thus, the stage was set for an ideological battle of epic proportions. The Cold War was not just about ideology, it was a race for dominance on all fronts: military, technological, and even extraterrestrial. In the grand chessboard of this global conflict, proxy wars emerged as a key tactic. Superpowers chose to flex their muscles indirectly, using other nations as their battlegrounds. The Korean War, for instance, was a clear manifestation of this strategy. From 1950 to 1953, the United States and its allies squared off against China and the Soviet Union, but on the Korean Peninsula. The fighting was intense, the stakes were high, and the world watched with bated breath, but the superpowers never directly clashed. The Vietnam War was another such proxy conflict. From the mid-1960s to the mid-70s, the United States waged a bloody and controversial war against the communist forces of North Vietnam, who were backed by the Soviet Union and China. Though the war was fought thousands of miles away from American and Soviet soil, it was a tangible manifestation of the ideological struggle between capitalism and communism. But the Cold War was not limited to the battlefields of Asia. It extended even to the farthest reaches of space. The space race, as it came to be known, was a technological duel between the United States and the Soviet Union, with each striving to outdo the other in space exploration. The launch of the Soviet satellite Sputnik in 1957 sent shockwaves through the Western world, sparking a flurry of American efforts to catch up. The climax of this race came in 1969, when the United States put the first man on the moon, marking a significant victory for the West. The Cold War was not merely a battle of arms, but a battle of wits, technology, and ideologies. It was a complex and multifaceted conflict, the effects of which continue to shape our world today. The proxy wars and the space race were not just sideshows, they were integral parts of this global struggle for dominance. Every war has an end, and so did the Cold War. But how did this era of tension and rivalry conclude? The fall of the Berlin Wall in November 1989 was a powerful symbol of the Cold War's end. This concrete barrier, once a stark emblem of division, was brought down by the people it was designed to separate. Its collapse signified the beginning of the end for the Soviet Union and the Cold War. But what caused the Soviet Union's dissolution? Severe economic problems plagued the Union. Widespread corruption, a stagnant economy, and the immense cost of keeping up with the West in the arms and space races all contributed to its downfall. Politically, the Soviet Union was also struggling. Nationalistic movements within its republics and the growing demand for democracy were forces too powerful to suppress. With the fall of the Berlin Wall and the dissolution of the Soviet Union, the Cold War era ended, leaving a profound impact on the world.